I'm Liz Arbiter. I'm a veterinarian at the University of Pennsylvania School of Veterinary Medicine. Today in our lecture, we discussed what an equine veterinarian, an ambulatory veterinarian does, and then we went into a lot of specifics about lameness, how to work up lameness. We discussed what lameness is, we discussed how to see it, and then they watched a bunch of videos and got to vote on what they thought was lame. So there's a lot of tools we use to detect lameness. Usually we use our eyes. That's kind of the number one thing. We also discussed today a computer program that is trying to take the subjectivity out of lameness. It's an objective look at lameness, and it has some pros and cons. So we went over that a little bit today, but by and large, we use our eyes 99% of the time. What makes lameness so difficult to detect, and it is very difficult even for veterinarians, is that horses are not always cooperative. And so if a horse was a robot and it just jogged for us to see a lameness with no personality and no badness or attitude, then it would be very easy to see. But because they are living, breathing creatures, a lot of times they are not very cooperative, and it can make seeing lameness really difficult. Lameness can also be very, very subtle, where it's almost imperceptible to the eye. It's more of a rhythm abnormality. So lameness in general is really hard for people to learn how to do, and it just takes a lot of practice. I don't think it's important necessarily to introduce certain subjects to high schoolers. I think it's concepts. And so this is a very small microcosm, a very small aspect of veterinary medicine. There's probably 5,000 of these little lectures that we can give. This happens to be a very fun, interactive one, so I really don't think the subject matter is that important. I could have lectured on a ton of things, but really we're just trying to get them passionate and get them interested. If that interest is equine veterinary medicine, then great. If it's something else, then great. It's really just about having a positive experience at this age. If I hope they take home one thing from my lecture, really I just want them to have had fun. This is the same lecture that I might use on early veterinary students, and I just want them to have fun, I want them to feel engaged, and I want them to understand how complicated it is, because there's plenty of time for them to learn the details, but I just wanted to kind of give them an overview of what we do and why what we do is challenging and fun.